Now, here's one thing I recommend. Before you attach this top plate, center your servos. And the reason why is that this servo over here is landlocked. There's no way to really get a screwdriver in there, although you could probably get a little stubby one and work with it for an hour. It's just easier to not attach this plate. Then set up a receiver and plug each one of these, let's say, into the elevator channel or the aileron channel. And that way you can see, you know, where things are going. And obviously this one is not centered horizontally. So I'm going to pull it off, recenter it, and then do the same thing for this one. So this is a step you want to take right now. Hey guys, when you're putting this piece on, note the orientation of the holes. The holes will later have to match with this aluminum piece that fits over the top, and you're going to want to have the holes match up so that you can get the bolts installed here in these four positions. So make sure you do that. There are places in the instruction where they do say note orientation. That's one you could easily miss. So there you go. All right, now the next step involves getting the shaft into the center housing and then sliding this collar on, but leaving it loose. And then what we'll do is we see a hole here, and there is a pin that goes, that goes in that hole, and it will secure the main gear. So the main gear gets positioned. Get some debris out of there, just like that. And what you'll be able to see is a slot on the main gear. I've now lined up the hole with the slot, and the pin will simply enter that, and that's how it secures the rotational consistency. And this pin will not go in by itself. So I have a little ball peen hammer that I just use to tap the pin in. And we'll get that just about right. Didn't need that much help. And there's really no need to put any Loctite on this, because when you pull it back into the recess like this, it's not going to go anywhere. It just cannot move laterally. And if I ever had to remove it, it would be a real pain in the butt to have permanent Loctite in there. So that's how that goes. And then what you'll do is, pulling up on the main shaft or supporting it from the bottom, you slide this collar down where it's supposed to be, and that's where it's going to lock in place. After you slide the main shaft in with the pin installed down here, you'll seat this clamp and make sure there's no vertical play at all before you tighten it down with lots of Loctite. So this will move freely this way, but it has got no vertical slop, and that is key to eliminating vibrations in the helicopter.